Thank you very much. So my name is Martin. I'm from Zammert, and you already told much more than I usually say about me. And today I want to give you a short insight about Zammert. So I start with my presentation. If you have questions, just write it down. I will answer them after on. So the presentation is structured into four categories. What is Zammert? A short insight about the installation, how to work with Zammert, and the last one, I will answer the questions. What is Zammert? Zammert is a help desk and support platform for satisfied customer service. Zammert is open and fast, like your service should be. And Zammert is based on many years of experience with ticketing systems. In the beginning, in the introduction, already said, we started not from scratch. We started with a knowledge base and customer experience from many years with OTRS. And one day we decided, okay, we need to make it new and better. And the result is Zammert. And Zammert, the name Zammert comes from the Bavarian slang and needs with Zammert. We are this together with the customer. We are stronger, or we solve issues faster than against the customer. So some numbers. Zammert got released in October 2016. We count over 500,000 downloads. We are many times trending open source project on category Ruby on GitHub. We started Zammert with a complete new web tech stack, which is not so easy to understand for old programmers. So we thought it might be not so easy to get others to contribute, but just after 5 hours after initial release, we got our first contribution. So we were impressed that the community is adapting Zammert so fast and is bringing contributions just 5 hours after initial release. We also count many pull requests from outside, and also already told we got our first award after 4 weeks and the second award 16 weeks after initial release. So the key features from Zammert. Zammert is a native web application, so it feels almost like a desktop application. So we not reload the whole pages, we only reload certain application elements. And this makes Zammert very nice to use. So it's some kind of real-time working. Also, if a colleague is working on a ticket, for example, you directly see it in real time. So it makes really fun to work with it. We have a super fast full text search, which also includes searching for attachments. So as today, I don't know any other, also not commercial products which do this. And since Zammert is a native web application, we already do communicate with the Zammert server in the background via REST API and WebSockets. So this means also for you that you can use the whole advantage of all resources which are available in Zammert to start integrations via the REST API. And the last key feature is Zammert is open source, as you already thought. Yeah, the ticketing core features. We have autosave for tickets, so no losing information when a browser is crashing. We have easy data historization, so every action is in a history and you can see what user did what change. We have escalations, SLAs. We have collision detection, so we prevent from answering one ticket by two agents to the same time by probably different answers. And we have custom overviews on any ticket attributes. So you can create your own to-do lists for the agents to see the tickets on what they need to work on it. We have individual fields for tickets, customers, and users. So it's easy to create new attributes for tickets. For example, a category or a serial number for the devices where you get questions for. We have a customer chat for your public website. You can just insert it really easy and can also use Samad for communicating with customers on your website. We have awesome custom text modules via keyboard shortcuts. So an agent, even if the agent is technical and not so talented to write texts with correct grammar and so on, so the agents can insert text templates to have nice answers to writing nice answers to customers. And we have channels for social network integrations, for example, for Twitter and for Facebook. So you also can use Samad for CIS organization communication to do it on a central place and have all the advantages from a ticket or a help desk system. So how about the installation? I want to show you how easy it is to install Samad. Samad, we provide OS packages for Samad for different Linux distributions. For example, for CentOS, Red Hat, Enterprise, Linux, Debian, Ubuntu, and SLES. For databases, we use Postgres, MySQL, or MariaDB. And as search engine, full text search engine, we use Elasticsearch. So here the steps how to install Samad, really easy. Install on a CentOS, for example, install the extended repo for additional packages, import our repo key, add the repository, and then you need to install Samad. After Samad is installed, you can also connect Elasticsearch to work as search backend engine. So this are the 7 steps to install Elasticsearch. It's also quite easy. As the last command is the only command which you need to integrate Elasticsearch into your Samad environment. Then after this is done, Samad will say hello with the starting screen. From here, you can decide if you want to set up a new instance or if you want to migrate from another system. Today, we support migration from OGRS or from a Zendesk installation. Yeah, now a closer look to how to work with Samad as an application. So this is a typical app structure. So on the short introduction to this, on the left top side, you have a global search beside of sets with the Samad Phoenix, which you also can see in my backside. It's a painting from my kids, by the way. You have the notifications on the right of the search area. And below you have the dashboard, the overviews. The overviews are the tool to serve the agents' lists of tickets where they should work on it. So you can also call it working lists or whatever, where the agent finds a word. Work where they should work on it. And below of that, we have a task bar. So you can open tickets, several tickets, and start working on tickets on multiple times. I will have a closer look on this later. Here on the top, you have your personal settings, reporting area, administration area, and here you can create new tickets. Here you have the content area. I will show this content area more in detail. Here we have a normal ticket detail view and more on this in the next slides. A closer look to the tabs. Here it's important we have, you can open multiple tabs on, at the same time. You can reorder them like you want. Unsaved changes to this formulas and so on are saved on server side. So if the browser is crashing or you want to log in from home and finishing some tickets, you will, if you log in from home, you get all the whole Xamarin Desktop and all your formulas back, and can you do not have losing of data which are not saved to the database right now. And in the front of tickets, we have this circle, and if the circle is pulsing, you have a change on this ticket. So the customer maybe have answered, or another agent has added a note or phone note. So you know there has something changed. I can click on this ticket and see what information has changed. Yeah, all changes are pushed to the clients immediately. So it's some kind of real time. Or it's real time, so you have no race conditions anymore between page reloads, because everything is done immediately, and also shown to the others immediately. We have to support the agents. We have colors used for ticket states. So just as a short, small example, we support the agents to have more brain power to work on tickets and not to organizing them or find tickets. So for example, closed tickets, we show green, and open tickets, which where agent need to work on it, we show in this orange color. And for example, escalated tickets, we have a red color. So the agent just sees the ticket in an overview and knows the state about it, and know, okay, if this is escalated, I need to have a closer look in it. Probably I should immediately work on it to solve the escalation. And green tickets are already closed, and there need not to be too much attention of the agent on these tickets. Yeah, here's the ticket detail view. So now the content area here. Here we have, in the middle, we have the different articles, which are the communication steps between the communication between agent and customer, or your organization and the customer. And this blue one are information from the customers, and this one is information from the agent to the customer. So you easily can have an overview what is the state of this communication by just browsing this ticket. And on the right side, you have the sidebar with the ticket information. So here you can change the group of the ticket, the owner of the ticket. You can close it or say set different other things. In the middle sidebar, in the next one, you have customer information and organization information. Here a detailed view of a customer. So if you click on this customer on the icon, you get this detailed view. And here you have information of the customer from this ticket. Here, for example, this information is usually taken from a customer database. And here we have an overview about the open or closed tickets of this customer. And here is an example of the organization overview. And here in this organization overview, you have the, also the information of the company and also the members of this company. So probably there are more users for this company which can create tickets. And below you have the information what tickets this organization has in your Xamarin instance. So you have not only an overview about one user, also about the whole organization. Yeah, a short analyze of the full text search to see how powerful this Xamarin full text search is. So in the beginning, we did some research because we feel or we usually, if you use an application for several years, the first thing which go down from the user experience is the full text search. So we did and it invested some time to do some research, and we installed other systems, even commercial systems, and we started to fill the systems with information. And as you can see, on a small installation with 50,000 tickets and the total usage of the system is about 5 GB, Xamarin has a much, the blue one is the Xamarin 1.0 version, has a fast full text search within 1 or 2 seconds, and other systems have about 4 seconds. And here in the last one, as compare, on a huge system with 500,000 tickets and 45 gigabytes data in there, usually other systems take up to 40 seconds for showing a search result, and Summit is still below 5 seconds. So from the end is searching attachments too. So here it's really nice to see, to have a really good performance for the full text search. Yeah, to the key features in the UI, as I already said, we have this custom overviews, the ticket lists, the agents can work on it, which you can create how many you want. Then we have a permanent markup. For example, an agent can say, I want this text is important, I can mark it, and other agents will also see it, that there is something important in it. And here an example of our shortcuts from this text module. So it's easy to use double point, and now you get a widget opened, and you can search for text modules or can enter new words, and the result is only showing the text modules which matching these words, and you can use the keyboard or the mouse to select these text modules. And by this way, you can easily write nice texts also for really technical people which are not so familiar with grammar and so on. And it's looking much better than the agent need to start from scratch with every response to customers. And we also have macros. So for example, if you need to, your agents need to work or to change certain attributes on for certain processes, you also can use macros in Summit to execute one macro with several actions for this ticket. And here a screenshot how to create new attributes for or individual fields for attributes. For objects, in this case for a ticket, you just need to say a new attribute, and you can say what kind of attribute is it, a normal input field, a date field, or a complex like a category tree and so on, and can create this and manage and administrate these attributes by this admin UI. Yeah. So I see the time is going fast forward. So I'm almost done with my presentations. I want to ask you if you have questions. I see.
So yeah, there are a few questions. You can take a look at the shared notes. I'll just read out some of them. Are you familiar with Qix?
Yes. Unfortunately, I do not see the chat notes somewhere. But however, Qix is another product, not our own product. It's a fork from OTRS. And so is there a special question for Qix regarding Qix?
Yeah. So since you can't see, I'll just read out the questions for you.
Thank you.
The first question is, how do you compare to OTRS or Qix?
Yeah, so as I started OTRS in 2001, I learned many things about how to work in custom environments, and Summit is a complete rewrite, but the focus is more to have to cover more easier and common use case, because if you know OTRS or Qix, it's a huge system with many configuration options, and it's you need a training to get it administrated and set it up, and Summit has a easier approach, so you can install it and Summit is done the easy way. So I think this is the main difference between these tools.
Okay. Two more questions. But the second question is, Do you have an overview of the technologies you use to build your service? For example, backend, front-end design framework. I know earlier on you mentioned a few databases.
Yeah, I can tell it because it's just simple. So right now in the backend, we use Ruby on Rails. So it's a REST interface. And on the frontend, we currently have a web application with JavaScript HTML5. And currently we use CoffeeScript in there because in 2016, we started in original in 2013. So it's the first 3 years, Summit was not public. CoffeeScript was a good choose, but we're going to rewrite the web application. So modern JavaScript, not CoffeeScript, is used anymore. And also Vue.js, for example.
There's another question about where you put your code repository for the project.
It's on GitHub and github.summit/summit.
Another question about Asian languages. Mm-hmm. Do you already have support for some Asian languages and are you looking for contributors?
We have support for different Asian languages, so it's no issue for us. And we also have some Asian contributors, but we are looking for contributors and also for people, for coders that we can pay for working for Summit. So if there is somebody out there, contact us or me. Or we have also a job description on our website, so you are welcome.
Another question about what you use for search.
For search, and I guess it's the technology. Here's a backend asked for. We use Elasticsearch right now, and we think about to support different backends, but currently it's Elasticsearch.
It's interesting how your open source technology is building on all these different open source technologies also. One more question about Summit itself. Is it possible to create orders from Viber messages or Telegram messages automatically?
Yes, of course. We support different channels because of the time of the limited time. I was not showing the whole channels, but we use normal web forms, emails, Twitter, Facebook, and so on, and of course also Telegram messages. So you can create a Telegram bot and connect it to Summit. And any time somebody writing you a Telegram message, your ticket is created in Summit, and you can do your conversation via Summit with the user, which is using Telegram on the other side.
It's truly end to end. So the final question for now, if there's more, feel free to put it in. But the final question for now is about a question about whether there are any aids to pass message text into structured data, for example, order details and addresses. I'm assuming there's something about maybe allowing it for exportation.
I do not understand the question in detail, so but I guess we have so in order
like,
you want
any tools that you have, for example, that can help you pass like this message text. Because for example, through like Telegram, right? Maybe you download Telegram, then Telegram messages. Is there a way to turn that into structured data formats?
So Telegram messages are already structured in Summit, in this ticket constructor and articles, which is a communication step between the others. And in order to have more structured information, we use stores in Rails in the backend. So it's more or less a hash store where usually if you do some integration with shops or whatever, they'll usually store data in it and can show this also in a formatted way via templates in Summit to show a ticket with the order information, for example. So here we use normal features from Ruby on Rails or from Active Record in this case, which makes you easy to create more integrations, and you can do fantastic things. So in this case we use the normal Rails functionality, which is awesome. It's really great, and the Rails guys that really do a really good job, and you can take the whole advantage from the Rails stuff. So there's no limitation on it, and you can directly use it on Xamarin.
That's actually about all the questions that we have for now. Once again, a quick reminder for Martin about the shared notes. I think that's written in German also, Geteilnotizen. I don't know. But basically, if you would like to still talk to Martin, because we only have about 2 minutes left, so you can still talk to him after this in the discussion room. If not, thank you so much for your presentation. And once again, I think you might want to refer to the notes on the left. Can you find it? Just a quick, maybe help you with this. Like move to the upper left hand, you see the user list toggle when you click it. Then you see like public chat, chat notes.
Yeah, now I see it, yes.
Yeah, there. That's where the questions are. Yeah, so this might be something for you to take away or carry with you. Yeah.
Okay.
Yep. Okay, if not, then that's about all the time we have for today. Thank you, Martin, for that very insightful